Hey guys and dolls, let's create a thumbnail image for a YouTube video, shall we? So first you're going to want to go to the site that I use, which is canva.com. It's not Canvas, it's Canva. Click it. Now I've already got an account, so I'm going to log in, but if you don't have an account, all you have to do is sign up here. It is free, and y'all know I love the free action, so that's what we're going to be doing today, is creating free images. Okay, so get logged in. This is going to be different than what yours looks like, because down here are all the images I've created. So when you first come in, obviously you will not have this. So let's say you want to create the thumbnail image, right? So you look up here, create a design, and you're looking across and going, oh no, there's not a thumbnail image. Oh no, what is it? All you have to do is click more. You can do custom dimensions if you want to, but I'm too lazy to do that. I like things done for me. So just come down here where it says social media and email headers, and you'll see right here the second one is YouTube thumbnail. You can always hover it, and you'll see the dimensions come up. So if you just want to double check, the size is current with what YouTube does. But for the most part, Canva is on the ball, so you can be safe in knowing that. Now when your workspace first comes up, this image, the white area that you see is where you're going to work, okay? And it's a little bit large for my taste, so I like to make it go a little bit smaller. So you'll see in the bottom right of the screen is the little zoom in, zoom out. And if you want to, up here you can see where it says YouTube thumbnail / untitled design. That's where you can put in the name of it. So let's just say I'm going to do YouTube thumb, okay? And you'll notice when I hit done, it'll change to YouTube thumb, okay? So now when it first comes up, you're going to see these templates here that you can use if you want. If you see it with a little, as you hover over it, if a little dollar comes up, that means it's $1 to use this template. Or you can use things like this where it says free. And like down here, you'll see the ones that say free. But let's say that we want to create one completely from scratch, not using a template. Okay, so what I'm going to do first is go to background, and I'm going to use only things that are on Canva today. If y'all want me to show you how to like upload your own images and things like that, let's get 1,000 likes on this video, and then I'll know that y'all want me to create another video that has that in it. Okay, so you can see here at the top again, we're back where it says free. And lots of different colors, lots of different patterns. Come down a little bit more, you get into like solid color and more patterns, stripes and things like that. And then again, as you go down, they have some really awesome backgrounds that again are just a buck. Okay, so totally worth it. I'm not going to scroll down because we would be here all freaking day long, and we don't have time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. So let's create one, since we kind of talked about puppies a minute ago. Let's create something maybe with puppies. Okay, so let's say we like a background that has let's say here's a swirly one down here. Let's do that one. See the little swirl? So I'm just going to click it, and it makes the whole background that, okay? Because we're in backgrounds and you're working on backgrounds, so all you had to do was click that image. Now let's say I don't really want it to be the shades of purple, so you're going to click it again, and you'll see up here, right here, this little color that comes up, that's telling you what color system that is. So let's click it, and let's say we want to make it light blue. Now let's do more dramatic. Let's say we want to make it this bright green color, okay? So we're going to click that. Now let's say we get that on there and that's not quite the shade we want. Just click the plus sign here, and you'll see you get the slider. Notice how the color changes on the image, okay? I'm literally just clicking and click and hold and then moving it with the mouse. So let's just pick a color. Let's just say right in. Let's go really bright. Let's go crazy obnoxious bright, okay? So we've got this great bright obnoxious green color, okay? Now what you can do, let's say we want to put in an image of a puppy. Okay, and I hope they have one. I didn't even look to see. We may have to create something else. But anyway, we were in background. Next, you're going to click elements. Now, what you could do is go through each of these to find what you want. Or the easiest thing you can write or do is just do a search. Put dogs. Click enter. And you'll see they do have a lot of images of dogs. And most of them cost a dollar. Okay, but I do see a couple here that are not a dollar. They're free. Okay, so let's go ahead and we're going to click hold and drag your element over. And then let's get this other guy. Click hold and drag this element over. All right, now let's say we want to make this a daddy dog and a mommy dog. And then baby dogs, okay? So let's scroll these down, or size these down a little bit, okay? So I've clicked the image, and you see my little arrow that kind of goes at an angle. Click again, hold, and scroll it down. So there's your daddy dog. And then click this dog again, same thing. Left click, hold, scroll down for the size. Let's say this is mommy dog. And then now what we can do, let's copy this image, okay? So literally I clicked it to highlight it. You can see the little selection box here and click copy. Does it right there. But let's scroll this one down because it's a puppy dog. It's a baby dog. So let's do this baby dog here. And then let's copy a daddy dog. So again, left click, get your selection, copy it. It's already selected. Scroll the size down and move it over. All right. Now let's say we want to change the colors of this dog to be the mommy dog. Okay. It's already selected, right? I'm going to go up here and I want to change these colors. So I want to change, let's say, the blue to this red color. So you're going to click the blue. You'll notice document colors come up. See, this is the background image. This is on the daddy dog and the mommy dog. This is on the daddy dog. There's the mommy dog's color. So if I click the red, look what happened. Okay, so now over here on this baby dog, let's make this one the color of the daddy dog. So again, the red color is what we want to change. Click it, document colors. It's already selected for you. How much easier can that be, right? Now let's say we want to put some text on there. So again, go back over here to the left to the text button. You can do, these are three different sizes as you can see. Let me show you how it pops up. You can do that, okay? And then, no, the one thing, oops, that was not what I wanted to do. The one thing you do have to do on this is either go ahead and type it or go outside of your working space. Just click to make that go away. Go back into your working space. You get the four quadrant thing. Click, left click, drag, and place. Okay. Now you can do this. And let's just say that we want to change the word to woof. All right. And let's change the color on it. It's already selected. Rainbow color selection up here. Let's make it purple to be crazy. And then let's say we want that a bigger size. I'm kind of going fast here. So again, leave it in the comments below if you have any questions and I will answer them. Or if I need to make a second video, I can do that as well. Okay, so let's say we wanted to say woof. Now let's say we want to have something down here. You'll notice on this text tab also where we have these three selections of different sizes, you can scroll this down and see kind of some pre-done things. All right, these obviously are going to have a solid background. These obviously are just going to be the text themselves. So let's say we're going to do, let's do this one because again it's free. Hopefully it won't be too large. And I literally clicked it. It automatically centers it. Actually, you know what? I don't like that one because it's too much. So I just click the trash can. Let's do, I know I'm kind of going fast. Again, let me know. Let's do this one. This will be an easy one to do. The automatic default is centered in the working space. Okay. So let's say we want to move it. See my arrow here? Watch as I move it in. Okay. Because it's already got the selection box. It's those four arrows. Left click, drag it to where you want it to go, and you can center it. Hopefully y'all can see the grid lines popping up of where centering is and things like that, okay? But let's say this is a little bit too big for what we want. Again, it's still selected, right? So you're just going to come down to the corner, and you're just going to scroll it into the size that you want. And then let's say it goes right here, and then it'll say, let's do this, watch this video about, not videos, video about dogs. Okay, now do you see what happened here? how it spread as I was typing in. It was too, you know, obviously the banner wasn't long enough. So all you have to do, it's still selected. Notice those boxes are still selected. Now, even though it's text inside of this element of the banner, they're both selected. So this is for in the text area because it's got that vertical cursor. Is for, go right outside of it. Then I get that four arrow come up. So just come down here and, oops, and then stretch it out. Remember how I made it bigger a minute ago? By getting the corner. Okay, we don't want it bigger. We just want it wider. Okay, and you're going, oh no, the text didn't work. Okay, go back outside the work area to click to, you know, let go of all those things. Click right over the text. See how it comes up. And let me see if I can't grab the... Ooh, it's not going to work. Okay, sometimes on their elements, because they're created differently, they don't necessarily do what we want it to do. So, here we're going to do this. If you're in working on it, this is what you do. I don't like that. Delete it. So now, go back to elements. Go up here in the search area. Put banner. All the banners will come up, and again, some are free, some are not. This one looks closest to what we had. Click it. Puts it in the center by default. It's still selected, so I'm just going to click and drag down. Okay, it's there outside the workspace to let it go. So you can go in here, double click to get the text. Now we can do watch this video about, oops, if I can type, about dogs. Okay, now here is where you're actually going to grab, and it should, is it not going to do it again? This is frustrating. Why is that not working? Well, let's try again, shall we? And this is sometimes, you know, again, I didn't do this coming into it, so, and I'm not editing this because I want y'all to see. Watch this video about dogs. Now, it should stretch out. These normally will, there we go. See how it popped down? So you just keep stretching that banner. And just like what I did, sometimes that's going to happen. Sometimes you're going to get an element that doesn't work. Now, let's say, well, we, you know, wanted those other colors. So again, just like we did up here with the puppies, go up and I want to change this color to be yellow. And I want to change the brown to be the same color as in the mama dog. Okay, and then you'll notice how that's on the banner itself. Now, if you want to change the text color, because it's a separate element, come in here and let's say we'll just make it black for simplicity. Oh, and it changed my size. There we go. All right, so here's a very janky, crazy colored thing. All right, so there's your image. It is the size that you need, and it's got all of these different elements that you want. So all you need to do here is you... share it if you want to. I never do because this is where you can like tweet it or post it or embed or link. But what I normally do, just the easy thing is just download that image and then you can choose what format you want it to be in. I usually do PNGs, but sometimes it's too big and I have to do a JPEG. So, and then of course, if you want to print them or whatever. But that is it. That is how you make a thumbnail image for a YouTube video. So let me know in the comments below. Did you like my janky tutorial? So, again, if you want me to do, you know, if you have questions, leave it in the comments below. Or if you want me to do more in-depth videos on this, let's get 1,000 likes on it, all right? So on that note, guys and dolls, have a delicious, delightful, delirious day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.